This video will highlight the results of the testing of the ED2 mmWave wave outside-in Roadrunner repeater. Tests were conducted in Tucson, Arizona on Verizon's 5G network at 28 GHz with permission in October 2020. There were two locations tested, both near central Tucson. The results were very encouraging, lighting up indoor locations that had no 5G coverage to hundreds of megabits per second. 3 handsets were used during the testing: the OnePlus device, the Motorola Edge Plus device, and the Qualipox device, specifically designed for testing by Rohde and Schwartz. The ED2 repeater tested consisted of 2 units: a donor unit, which is positioned within the service arc of a G-Node B, and a service unit, which is positioned wherever coverage is needed. The 2 units are connected with 4 coax cables and can be separated by hundreds of feet if needed. The first test site was formerly a Boston Market location. Verizon 5G service was quite good at the exterior of the building. There was a 5G site with direct line of sight to the location. The GNB and the location were approximately 566 feet apart from the tower to the front door. At the exterior of the building, throughputs were easily above 400 megabits per second and got faster as the test units got closer to the tower. Once inside the building, there was essentially no 5G service at all. The ED2 team set up the donor units outside the front door of the facility. The restaurant was not operational, so this was not a problem. The service unit was set up inside the lobby. Under normal circumstances, this would be mounted on the ceiling or in a corner, which would deliver better results, but for initial testing, this was okay. Once the repeater was turned on, the coverage inside the facility went from zero 5G service at all to hundreds of megabits per second. We'll call this a win. The second location was a much larger space, the St. Francis Church. The interior we were looking to test is approximately 5,000 square feet. The Verizon GNB is very close, just at the edge of the parking lot, which made this a nice test site. We took readings just outside the church entrance and the service was excellent, many hundreds of megabits per second. It's worth noting, for the in-building wireless experts watching, that there's a large 4G tower right on the other side of the property. This was delivering very good 4G service right into the facility, so we were wondering if the dominance of the 4G signal would overpower a UE attempting to attach to the 5G signal. Although 4G was super strong, once the repeater was operational, the UE switched from 4G to 5G, so we were quite happy with that result. Smart networking from Verizon. We set the donor unit up in the parking lot, about 30 feet from the front door, where the service unit was going to be placed. The GNB was so close, we tilted the donor a bit. We had to crank the attenuation all the way up. Here's a look at the inside of the interior. We set the service unit up just inside the door at about waist level. The antennas on the unit were plus minus 90 degrees, so a pretty good setup to cover a space like this from a corner. 5G millimeter wave coverage is complicated. Signals bounce around quite a bit. We took measurements all over the interior of the site. The results were crystal clear, from no coverage at all inside to blazing fast 5G. We were super excited. ED2 Corporation is delivering millimeter wave coverage that will enable 5G to gain the sort of traction this industry is counting on. Thank you for watching. Please feel free to contact us at any time with questions or just to engage. At ED2, we're making 5G happen.